This is Yamaha xv1600 Roadstar valve adjustment. What happens to rocker arm? One rocker arm works two valves. Two here, two on the rear cylinder. The valves never wear evenly, so they have to be adjusted periodically to keep the noise down. So what you do right here, that's a 10 millimeter. I use a quarter inch drive. I've already done it, but I'm gonna go through how I done it, how to do it. I take the four spark plugs out. Well, not out, but the plug wires, take the plug wires off, turn the key on, watch the valves, watch that intake right here. See the exhaust open? Do the intake. Right after the intake shuts is when you want to do it. There's a period where they're both shut. Right after the intake shuts, or when you know the exhaust is down, you can do the intake. This saves having to take everything off on the left side and turning the crank over to get it top dead center with the nut, with the bolt on the end of the crank. So you just bump it around. See, the exhaust is open, so we can do the intake now. You can do the opposite. You watch it. Watch the exhaust up here. Okay, see that intake opening? Now we can do the exhaust. All it's about is those two valves, like my fingers of the valves. This is dramatic, but they wear unevenly. So if you back off, this adjuster is only on one side, the other side just a straight metal pad, and that's it. I take the lock nut all the way off, and I use a little baby magnet when I'm close to getting it off. I reach in here like this, and then the way I don't drop it, and it just makes life easier on me. So anyway, with the nut all the way off, loosen this off to where it's handy by hand. Then you tighten it back up till there's resistance. What that's doing, the hydraulic lifter keeps it pressured up on the one without the adjuster. So you make up the difference here. Doesn't really matter which valve's worn, but with the lifter keeping the other one on, when you loosen this up and slack it, then you just screw it back down till there's resistance, meaning you know you're screwing it onto the valve. Stop right there, lock your lock nut down, and you're good. And these, I have a small bike shop here. These Yamaha 16, 1700s notoriously rattle. So you're probably gonna have to live with some rattle, but that's all you can do. Get it to top dead center, or right when you see the intake shut, adjust them. Or like I said, the easier way, when the exhaust, you know for sure it's trying to open, adjust the intake. When the intake's trying to open, adjust the exhaust. Loosen it up by fingers with the nut off. Tighten it down by fingers till there's resistance. Then, what I do to be sure, I take these needle nose, stick it on that without the nut on it, and hold a certain pressure on these needle nose to try to tighten it and see if it, I hold a pressure to where it'll loosen, but then when I go to tighten it, the jaws slip on my pliers. But it will loosen, but then it slips. That tells me I'm loosening, then I'm getting down to zero lash. It takes more torque then, so my pliers spin by just holding a certain pressure here. That's how I know for sure that I'm not hung up a little dirt on the thread or something. I do it with those holding a certain pressure. After I've done it with fingers and ran them down to I think I know it's right, then I clamp it with the pliers, loosen it, and watch it loosen, and tighten it, watch it tighten, and then my pliers will slip because I'm not bare gripping the pliers. All you're trying to do, make sure you loosen it up, run it down till it touches. Best way for me to do that is with the nut off. I run it out loose with my fingers back in till it won't move with my fingers. Then I verify that with my pliers loose, tight, slip. It'll loosen, try to tighten it, it'll slip. That lets me know. Lock it and you're good. That's all you can do for it. You're probably gonna still have a little rattle. This is my personal bike, it's always rattled. It's an 03, I love it. I've had a lot of bikes. I ride a lot of bikes. So far, this has been my favorite. Simple to work on, simple layout, easy to yank the carb off. It's about due. I got a kid over here, but not today. I'm about to take a road trip. But that's all there is to it. To take the gas tank off, you got your little plug in the back. You got the two plugs in the front right here. The three bolts on the dash. Take the dash off. You got your vent. Pull the key out. The gas line on the other side. 10 millimeter all the way through bolt nut here. So you got your nut, your fuel line, this plug, these two plugs, the chrome, the vent, and you're done. The tank's off. Then by bumping it over, and you can verify yourself, take your time, you know. Monkey with it enough till you get the feel of what's going on, what it's doing. And you'll teach yourself the feeling of when it's tight and when it's not. Leave the spark plugs in it, because that way you don't drop a valve cover screw down in the piston hole and go fishing for the rest of your life. Wishing that you had a horse instead of a motorcycle. All right, I'm Geezer Moto. This is number two. I'm 59 years old. I've been doing this all my life. I'll be posting more videos as I go. Just ABC, cut to the chase. I don't monkey around. I don't got to wear gloves. You know, I don't got to have a funky fedora. I just do the work. All right, Merry Christmas.